with an injury.
Written off because of the injury.
Written off. Cast off. Jamal Williams, former Green Bay Packer.
Mm-hmm.
Written off.
Never got a shine.
Didn't get a reach. Yeah, was a backup.
Mm-hmm.
Here, now here in Detroit. Island of Lost Toys. Josh Reynolds, cut by the Tennessee Titans midseason.
Yes.
Picked up here. Having a hell of a season with Jared Goff and the boys, too. Cast off. John Kaminsky, waived by the Atlanta Falcons.
Yeah.
Picked up here. Another cast off. Deshaun Elliott. Guy was number 10 for the Pro Bowl voting right now. Mm-hmm. Didn't get a shine in New Baltimore. New Baltimore is a city here in Michigan. Yeah. Baltimore. Cut here now. Opportunity here in Detroit.
Making the most of
and
it.
And yes, even your quarterback, Jared Goff, traded alongside two first-round picks for a guy the organization that drafted him and went to the Super Bowl with him thought was an upgrade over him. It is a team of gritty guys.
Mm-hmm.
They all had the door slammed in their face. They all feel like they weren't given enough opportunity. And the crazy part about this, Spinny, is it's all done by design. Brad Holmes and Dan Campbell chose these guys.
Yes.
As soon as we've seen Levi Anzarike drafted, he's a guy who sat there in the draft room in front of media is like, I just want to whoop some ass.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And like, just gritty dudes. Even the head coaches. I'm sorry, not the head coaches, but the assistants. The coordinators. Ben Johnson, first year OC, something to prove.
Mm-hmm.
Second year DC and Aaron Glenn, something to prove. You know the story of Deuce Daly, been well documented.
Yep.
He was with the Super Bowl winning organization, the Philadelphia Eagles. He left that to have an opportunity here in Detroit to bring up his own name. You have the same situation. It's all over the place, but again, it's by design. Think about the selling points here in Detroit. It's never in the free agency meetings with Brad Holmes and these new guys. It's never like, hey, you come here, you're going to win some games. No. You come here, you know, bust your ass off, and you have an opportunity to either get paid by us or someone else. You have actually opportunity to see the floor, or I'm sorry, see the field. Mm-hmm. You know, we had court-sized seats, so actually said floor. My bad.
We were seeing the floor.
Yeah, no big deal. We said floor. No big deal. But you have the opportunity to get paid. You have the opportunity to get some PT to prove, like, who you are. And, like, that's just what you build here, man. We would have a bunch of gritty guys that want to grind through. And you've seen it throughout the season. You start the season 1-6.
Yeah.
It's a tough mentality.
It is.
To like, thug through that, finish back, and now you're sub 500.
That's what it was. And this was never the question of Dan Campbell. When Dan Campbell was hired, you knew he was a leader of men. You knew he was someone who would galvanize the locker room, which is why they went from extreme A with Matt Patricia and his stupid pencil and his rocket science and all that dumb crap, thinking he's the smartest guy in the room at all time, and bringing in a guy like Dan Campbell, who is a get-down-to-business, obviously former player, so he knows locker rooms, he knows behaviors, he knows what it takes in the NFL. You bring him in, you know he is going to bring that locker room together. You know he is going to get those guys to buy in to what he is selling, because they're like, okay, he's been there, he's done it before, not only as a player, but as a coach, as an assistant head coach in New Orleans under Sean Payton. That's pretty good. That's a pretty good person to stand under. And you look at, again, like you said, this team started 1-6. How easy would it have been for these guys to be like, all right, we're done, it's over, we're just going to go through the motions? No. They stayed attached. They stayed into it. You have how many rookies and second-year players performing at a high level in all facets of the game, on defense, on offense, in special teams. These guys are making plays on a weekly basis now. It's not a fluke. Kirby Joseph getting 2 forced fumbles, 2 interceptions in the first 3 games is not a fluke, because you see him continuing to produce at that level. Amon-Ra St. Brown at the end of last year doing what he did is not a fluke, because now he is a top 10 receiver in the NFL making plays on a weekly basis. Aiden Hutchinson, his game against the Washington Commanders was not a fluke, because now you see him every week in the opponent's backfield causing havoc for other teams. Malcolm Rodriguez, 6th round draft pick. His start was not a fluke, because you see him come back in from injury and be that same dog who was on the field in the first couple games. Dan Campbell has these guys bought in. He has them performing at a high level. And like I said a couple weeks ago, now they are playing disciplined, opportunistic football, which is how you win in the NFL. And it is an impressive thing to see when you have a head coach who these guys, obviously, you know, everyone knows, the media in the first, you remember how hard the national media switched on Dan Campbell. When he was first hired, oh, this guy's a joke. Look at the double shot, the bite kneecaps. Who's this guy? And now you watch Hard Knocks. You get to know him a little bit. You feel like you know him because you're seeing the behind-the-scenes stuff. I'd run through a brick wall for this man.